YouTube has many videos discussing the importance of using probiotics to support fertility. Of course, many of these are from companies who are selling probiotics. Is there any scientific evidence to support these claims? Should you be using probiotics? Stay tuned. What are probiotics? Simple. Probiotics are live microorganisms such as bacteria and yeast. These bacteria are either eaten or in some cases may be inserted into a body cavity. For fertility, for example, some recommend putting probiotic bacteria directly into the vagina. I know what you're thinking. Bacteria causes infections. Why would anybody want to put bacteria into the vagina? Here is the logic. Turns out that human beings are covered in bacteria inside and out. There is bacteria in your mouth, stomach, and intestines. There are also bacteria that are normally in the vagina and in the uterus. All of the bacteria in a given portion of the body is called a microbiome. Many types of bacteria appear to be essential for normal health. We will call these good bacteria. In the vagina, for example, a group of bacteria called lactobacilli are thought to be good bacteria. People who have low levels of these bacteria may be predisposed to vaginal infections from other bad bacteria. This is known as bacterial vaginosis. Some studies have tried giving people probiotics with lactobacilli to prevent or treat bacterial vaginosis. The results have been mixed at best. A number of studies have tried to determine whether people with bacterial vaginosis are at increased risk for infertility. A few small studies found that bacterial vaginosis is more commonly found in infertility patients than in pregnant patients. Another few studies found that it was more common in people with tubal infertility compared to other causes for infertility. However, at least six studies found no difference in IVF pregnancy rates between people with bacterial vaginosis and those without. Here is an important point. Just because bacterial vaginosis is found more commonly in people with infertility does not mean that it is the cause of their infertility. But let's assume that it is the cause. Is there any evidence that probiotics can improve natural fertility? After an extensive search, I was not able to find any studies which looked at the impact of probiotics on natural pregnancy rates or miscarriage rates. Therefore, any practitioner, website, post, or video that says that probiotics will improve your natural fertility are doing so without any scientific evidence to back them up. Could probiotics help improve IVF success rates? There have been several studies looking at this. However, no studies so far have found a higher IVF pregnancy rate by using probiotics. None. Why not? Why didn't these studies improve IVF success rates? A very interesting study was just presented at the annual meeting of the European Society of Human Reproduction and Embryology, known as ESHRE. In this study, researchers recruited 74 IVF patients who had a low amount of the good type of vaginal bacteria, lactobacillus. These people were randomly assigned either to receive vaginal probiotic capsules or a placebo capsule without any probiotic. When they checked the levels of vaginal bacteria after treatment, they found something surprising. The patients who took the placebos had a 40% increase in the amount of good bacteria, and those taking the actual probiotics, there was only a 29% increase in good bacteria. This is important because it indicates that over time, the vaginal microbiome can improve on its own without any help. It also demonstrates that probiotics may fail to increase IVF success rates because they fail to improve the vaginal microbiome. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. At this point, there is no evidence that demonstrates that probiotics can improve fertility or decrease miscarriage risk. There is no evidence that it can improve IVF success rates. Other than the expense, however, there does not appear to be much harm to using probiotics. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.